here we are once again. I am the Ugly Truth, working with WeAreChangeToronto.org. It is Saturday, February the 5th. This is a second in a series of rallies in support of Egypt. I was covering the event last week along with Darcy from We Are Change, and here yet again to show once again solidarity with the people of Egypt and to cover the event. Let's see what's happening.
So he has to go now, and the world can't wait until September when he decides to step out.
What will happen is you will manipulate the system, you will turn around with all demonstration and support, and you will say, well, I have to stay here for long.
Again, we're here to stand in solidarity with the people of Egypt after 30 years under the dictatorship of Hosni Mubarak. People want change there. Economic times are very hard there. There's a lot of political and social injustice, and people have risen up to make their voices heard. So we're here in Toronto to show our support and to cover the event. Again, WeAreChangeToronto.org.
We have now is yes, democracy, and I guess it's better to keep like this. And when I say no Mubarak, when I say no Mubarak, you just turn it. Yes, democracy.
اللي بيفرق بعده ناس
اللي بيفرق بعده ناس
stop.
We had a protest last Saturday in support for the people of Egypt. We had almost 1,000 people, if not more. This is a great message we're sending out to people in Egypt, everywhere across Canada and the world. I've spoken with friends and family and I've told them what we're doing here in Toronto, and they are Torontonians as well, and they send their thanks, their greetings, and just support for us as well for supporting them. So a great round of applause for that. My name is Lama Ibrahim. I'll be co-emceeing this along with Michael Fanous. We're going to get underway. I'd also like to thank the following organizations who've supported us in organizing this event today. They include the Canadian Coptic Association, the Egyptian National Association for Change, the Toronto Egyptian Solidarity Campaign, the Canadian Arab Federation, the Canadian Peace Alliance, the Toronto Coalition to Stop the War, all the amazing volunteers that helped us put this together, including the sign and spreading the word and everything, and of course you yourself. Thank you very much for coming out today. The University of Toronto.
First reason we are here is for democracy in Egypt. And the other reason we are here is to call on all Canadian political parties to say, Mubarak, leave now! Before we begin with our chanting, our speakers, and our march, we want to send a message to those in Tahrir Square and elsewhere in Cairo, Alexandria, Suez, and all of Egypt. We want to say that their lives are valuable, that their government, the regime right now, may not hear their calls or respect their lives. But we here are going to stop our protest for a moment of silence to commemorate the 300 lives that have been lost since January 25th in the protests. Afterwards, there'll be a spoken word by Noura, but I call on everybody right now to stop for a moment in silence for those that have lost their lives for freedom.
Presentation by Noura. It's a spoken word that she wrote last night with everything that was happening. So please give her your attention.
Sorry, I just wrote this last night, like she said, and I haven't memorized it. And secondly, I'm only a high school student, so I'm sorry if I say anything wrong. I'm not really, you know, pro politics. I've been chewing my lips for too long, they're starting to bleed, my roots are strong because I'm of your seed. So today, I'll break through the soil, let my tongue taste the sun, and with the top of my lungs, I will scream freedom. Because I am sick of people talking to themselves on the streets, where you have to shove your way out shoulder to shoulder like you say. It's blown up churches across mosques, blood spilling on churches and mosques, stained pictures of Isa, stained words of the Quran. So now we're elbow to elbow, dropping our hearts to pick up rocks. I've never seen so many people wear their hearts in their sleeves, hope for hope and live in their dreams. Struggle for bread, fatabur al-aish, we struggle for bread. And some spend months before having to taste some protein. Hospitals falling while officials keep change in their pockets. Iron suits and polished shoes. Kids hooked on shoe polish. They talk about change but never really talk about change. How many train accidents are we counting? How many runaway boats are drowning? Are we still counting? Mother, we stood silent for years while we let him and his posse take turns raping you, blood dripping down your knees, and all we ever do is shed tears. We are the children you never planned for, 85 million, but you still held the burden on your hips. You are the golden eagle, jammed between the red and the black, flutters a little, then starts to sag. So let your talons rip through the fabric, let your craws deafen those who never listen, because today we share Aish wa Malh, like they say. Silence was overcome by whispers. Thousands gathered to pray the Sheikh and Baba hand in hand. Zamalkawi, Ahlawi, hand in hand. Soccer cheers, now chants for freedom. Boys take walks with broomsticks and garbage bags, sweep streets while youth govern traffic and secure homes, protect shops from secret police. We're robbing us for 30 years. Mubarak, look what you've done in 30 years. Stacked billions and starved millions. Greece sparks the revolution, so watch out, Mubarak. Lose the confusion and stop the delusion. We hate you. We hate your two-faced politics, the plastic surgery on your face, you and your posse. So don't try to act brave. We hate you and your posse. So follow the footsteps of Zayn. And no, you are not the only soldier on the 6th of October, so don't call yourself a hero. And no, history will be a witness and God is the judge, so go ahead, take our textbooks and smudge the names of marchers. Get your minister to lock kids' minds in dungeons. Get your Winstons to rewrite history over and over. So your charters follow your history, and history becomes nothing but your fantasy. But we are still human. We have dignity, we have souls, we have reason, we have souls, so don't treat us like children. Ground us up and lock us up in our homes, closing the internet and phones. Feeding propaganda, international TV, flipping truth upside down and not saying a soul about the number of marchers, mysterious disappearances of security forces and security vans, chasing protesters like kids chasing ants, kidnapped reporters and protests outside of your borders, your speeches are as fake as your prison breaks. And while Egypt is our mother, Mubarak, you are not the father. You're like 85 years of age, man. Won't you have some shame? Your retirement is 20 years late. Your retirement is 20 years late, so please, you've had your 30 years, now give your people a break. Thank you.
We have Mohammed Ashukr, representative of the Egyptian National Association of Change. I'd like to invite him up to say a few words to us.
Thank you. Brothers and sisters, we are here today to celebrate the great uprising of the Egyptian people against the tyrannic regime of Mr. Mubarak. We are here to commend the struggle and support the struggle of Egyptians to rid themselves of the oppression after 30 years. The Egyptian people today are writing a new chapter in their history, and they are crossing the road to freedom, and we are all behind them. The Egyptian people are setting to the world an example of peaceful, civilized, and non-violent revolution. Egyptians have been demonstrating tirelessly in the past 11 days to demand the removal of the regime, not only the removal of Mubarak, but his entire regime. Clear demand. And let me explain very briefly, in four brief points, what we mean by removal of the regime. We demand the freedom of Egyptians to elect their representatives and their president in free election. That's the first demand. We demand the lift of the emergency law and the excessive police power that has been in effect in Egypt for the past 30 years. And this is what Mubarak has used in order to impose his iron rule. We demand the stop to the corruption of the government officials, the ministers who use their position to get bribes and illegal commissions. We demand the return of the wealth of Egypt from the billionaires, including Gamal Mubarak and the family of Mubarak, today, in the Guardian, in the British Guardian today, there is a report that this family has accumulated 70 billion Egyptian pounds during the 30 days. This is wrong. and this is Egyptian money, and this is what we demand to return to the people of Egypt.
$7 million
multiplied by 5.75. Yes, yes. We are here today to demand the change of the regime. This is what the change of the regime means. It is not enough for us, for Mubarak, to remove all the gangs that have been ruling Egypt illegally and in a much corrupt fashion. They have to remove with him. We are here today to let our fellow Canadians, this is the message to the government and our fellow Canadians, we want to let them know that this regime has committed gross injustice to the Egyptian people. 43% of the Egyptians live on daily income between $2 to $3. 30% of Egyptians are illiterate. We are here today to let the Canadian, our Canadian fellows, citizens and the government, to let them know that they should not, we should not support a dictator who does not listen to his people, who smashes any force of reform and who came to power only through rigged election. We ask our government, to stick to our Canadian values and support the struggle of Egyptians for their freedom. Democracy and freedom. Democracy and freedom should be placed first above any corporate or political interest. Finally, our government has supported Mr. Mubarak in the past because he presents himself to the world as the superstar of the war on terror. And I would like to inform every one of us today that this Mr. Mubarak, the same Mr. Mubarak, inside his country, he has been the superstar of exercising terror against his own people. How ironic! How ironic! Finally, Egyptians today, as I said in the beginning, are crossing the road to freedom, and we are all behind them. We support their struggle to a safe and quick reach to their goal, and thank you very much.
Our first speaker is the Honorable Jack Layton, the federal leader of the New Democratic Party and member of Parliament for Toronto. Danforth, he has a few short words for us today.
Democracy for Egypt!
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 Thank you, sisters and brothers. Your voices are being joined with voices all around the world. Your voices are being joined by those who are gathering in the streets of Cairo today in a courageous, peaceful struggle for democracy and freedom. We call on the government of Canada to, first of all, disassociate yourselves from the approach being taken from the Mubarak administration. Yeah! Stop supporting Mubarak and start supporting the people, Mr. Harper. Yeah! Offer to the people of Egypt the full support of Canada in the transition to democracy. Yeah! The Canadian people believe fundamentally in the right of the people of Egypt to have a democratic state. And we can help, first, by adding our voices as a country and as citizens of this country to the struggle for democracy and equality and justice in Egypt. Secondly, by offering to help the people of Egypt to construct that democracy using the knowledge and expertise that we have developed over so many years, which has fallen some duty. Bring our home troops back from Afghanistan and let's start being envoys for peace in places like Egypt. It's a time of great hope, but it's also a time of great anxiety, and I can see this in your faces. Many of you that I've talked to have family back home. and you're worried about what's taking place, but at the same time you're hopeful about the possibilities. It's to have these two completely contradictory emotions in your hearts at exactly the same moment. It's very, very difficult. But it's hard to sleep, I'm sure. Some of you told me you haven't slept in several since this whole thing began. I just want you to know that in the House of Commons and across this country, the New Democratic Party will keep pushing for action and will push for our government to do the right thing. No to Mubarak. Yes to democracy in Egypt. Thank you very much.